Okay, good evening class. So for now, so let's continue the discussion. So this is in relation to the contract of sale, which is forms of a contract of sale. So doon sa contract of sale, forms of a contract of sale na diniscuss ko on the other video. So ito na yung kabuuan. So let's discuss now the statute of fraud. So we all know that maybe some of you did not understand so the statute of frauds or did not recall the statute of frauds. Maybe na-discuss na siguro ito during your obligations and contract na subject. So let's have a recall about the statute of frauds. So, okay. So first, what is statute of frauds? So statute of frauds requires certain contracts to be in certain forms. So, di ba class familiar, just like in a contract of sale. Di ba sa contract of sale, it is perfected by mere consent. Ibig sabihin, kapag meron ng meeting of the mind si seller at si buyer on the subject matter and the price certain, so there is a perfected contract of sale. But here, the statute of frauds requires a certain forms to be first to be enforceable. So dapat yung one of the contract must be in certain form para maging enforceable siya. Next is number two, it must be in certain form to be valid, maging valid yung kontrata. And then lastly, it must be in certain form to be convenience. So for the purpose of convenience. So now, so let's discuss statute of frauds requires the following to be in writing to be enforceable. So dapat the following must be in proper form. Number one, an agreement that by its term is not to be performed within a year from the making thereof. So dapat daw yung mga agreement or yung mga kontrata na a year pa mapaperform. So let's say for example, mayroong magpapatayo kami ng dream house, magpapatayo ako ng dream house. So ngayon, I consulted an architect or a contractor. So tapos na lahat yung plano ng bahay, lahat ng gagastusin, but yung construction is will begin after a year pa. So dapat yung kontrata namin ng contractor must be in writing to be enforceable. Next, number two, a special promise to answer for the debt, default, or miscarriage of another. So ibig sabihin class, a special promise to answer, just like for example, ako, may utang ako sa bangko. And then, ngayon, since lumapit ako ngayon doon sa bangko na pinagkakautangan ko, sabi ko magbabayad ako. Pero, yung utang is magjuju na. Ngayon, nakita kita doon, since ikaw marami kang business, marami kang pera, ngayon, we entered into an agreement na ikaw, since marami kang pera, ikaw yung sasagot sa mga utang ko. So ngayon dapat paano kapag yung agreement natin is made orally and then ngayon nag-due na yung utang ko, so thus can I compel you to pay my debt? So the answer is no. It's because our agreement entered it orally. So dapat ang sabi ng statute of fraud, dapat yung kontrata nating dalawa na sasagutin mo yung utang ko must be in form. So dapat it must be in writing. Next, number three, an agreement made in consideration of marriage other than a mutual promise to marry. So ibig sabihin daw, agreement made in consideration class ha, consideration of marriage but not promise to marry. So anong ibig sabihin nito? Just like for example, si Miss Ozaraga, let's say, she is a 30 years old. And then ngayon, nalulungkot yung tatay niya na baka maging laon siya. So ngayon, sabi niya, tay, magpapakasal na ako. So, siyempre, tuwang-tuwa yung tatay ni Miss Usaraga or yung parents ni Miss Usaraga. So, dahil tuwa sila, magbibigay sila ngayon na ibibigay sa kanila ngayon yung one unit of condo na nasa Makati. So, ngayon, sabi ni Miss, so, ibig sabihin, dapat, yung sabi yung dapat the consideration or yung pagkasabi ng parents ni Miss Usaraga na ibibigay sa kanya yung condominium unit, dapat it must be in writing daw para maging enforceable. So take note class ha, consideration of marriage ang tawag doon, naintindihan? So by way of joy, so yung parents ni Miss Usaraga tuwang-tuwa, so bibigyan daw siya ng isang condominium unit. So, dapat, it must be in writing to be enforceable. So, kapag hindi siya in writing, so, hindi, Miss Osaraga cannot enforce na kukunin yung condominium unit. Naintindihan? So, pero what if ganito class, hindi natuloy yung kasal nila. So, kapag hindi natuloy yung kasal nila, so Miss Usaraga cannot compel her fiancé to marry her. Hindi ka po pwedeng pumunta ng korte na pilitin mong pakasalan ka. So, magkaibang scenario yon. Magkaiba yung consideration of marriage at magkaiba din yung promise to marry. Next, number 4, an agreement for the sale of goods, chattels, or things in action at a price not less than 500 pesos. So, let's say for example, I have sabihin natin, iPhone 11. So, sabi ko, ebebenta ko sa inyo. So, kapag umuo ka dun sa price, umuo din ako. So, there is a meeting of the minds. So, there is perfected contract of sale. But, sabi ng statute of frauds, it must be in writing to be enforceable. So, take note class na. But, what if ganito class? Nagbenta ako sa inyo ng iPhone 11. And then ngayon, worth 10,000. So, since you are the buyer, nagbigay ka na ng down payment, sabihin natin 3,000 pesos. But our contract made orally only. So, through oral only. So, can I enforce the contract of sale? So, the answer is yes. Why? Statute of fraud class applies only to an executory contracts. Statute of fraud does not apply to an executed contract or partially executed contract. So, ibig sabihin, yung statute of frauds ay nag-a-apply lamang dun sa mga mangyayari pa lang na kontrata. So, hindi na siya mag-a-apply dun sa mga tapos na kontrata. So, dun sa example natin, by way of giving a down payment, so there is a meeting of the minds. Ibig sabihin, there is a perfected contract already, partially perfected contract already because it constitute down payment. So yun yung sinasabi dito sa unless the buyer accept and receive part of such goods and chattels or evidences or some of them of such things in action or pay at the time some part of the purchase money. So ibig sabihin, meron ng down payment na nangyari. Ibig sabihin, kapag nagbigay ng down payment yung buyer at inaccept ni seller, there are already partially perfected contract of sale. So, hindi na mag-a-apply doon yung statute of frauds. Naintindihan? So, kahit oral lamang yung kontrata nila, so, it is already enforceable. But when a sale is made by auction and entry is made by auctioneer in his sale of book at the time of the sale of the amount and kind of property sold, terms of sale, price, names of the purchasers, and person on whose account the sale is made it is sufficient memorandum. So, ano daw ibig sabihin ito? Doon naman sa sale by auction, so kapag meron ng fall of hammer, ibig sabihin there is already perfected contract. Naintindihan nyo? So, statute of fraud does not apply on the sale by auction kapag tapos na yung fall of hammer. So, next. Number 5, an agreement of the leasing of real property or any interest therein for a longer period than 1 year or for the sale of real property or an interest therein. So, syempre naman. So, dapat it must be, a contract of lease must be in writing. So, according to statute of fraud, kapag meron siyang yung contract of lease are longer than 1 year, so it must be in certain form. So, it must be in public instrument. Next, last, number 6, sale of real property or any interest therein regardless of the price. So, take note class ha, kapag real property yung pinag-uusapan, so kahit magkano yung presyo, dapat it must be in proper form or it must be in writing to be enforceable. So, next, number 7, a representation as to the credit of a third person. So, representation of a third person, just like for example, mangungutang ako sa banko or ikaw mangungutang sa banko. So, let's say for example, BDO. Mangungutang ka ngayon sa banko worth 1 million. And then ngayon, so, nandun ka, nakikipag-negotiate dun sa bank manager and at the same time, nandun din ako. So, sabi ng banko, hindi kita papautangin kasi you don't have the qualification. So, let's say for example, hindi mo kaya magbayad. And then ngayon, since magkakilala tayo, sabi mo dun sa bank manager, kilala ko ito. So, ibig sabihin, he will represent me. So, ibig sabihin daw, ikaw at ako nag-usap na ako ang magre-representa sa'yo. So, para lang ma-approve yung bank loan mo. So, what if yung kontrata nating dalawa is made orally? So, it will not enforceable. So, dapat sabi ng statute of fraud, it must be in writing to be enforceable. Naintindihan? So, let's say for example, hindi ka na pagbayad and then yung kontrata natin oral lang. So, you cannot enforce me to pay your debt. Unless lang kung merong it must be in, unless lang it is in writing. Next is for the purpose of validity. So, number 1, a contract of donation of immovable property must be in public instrument to be valid. So, let's say for example, magdo-donate kayo ng lupa. So, every time na mag-donate ka ng lupa, kapag oral lamang yung donation mo, it is not valid. Naintindihan? So, every time na magdo-donate ka, yung contract of donation must be in public instrument. So, it must be notarized. Number 2, contract of donation of personal property whose value is more than 5,000 must be in writing. So, take note of that class. To be valid, kung magbibigay ka ng personal property out of generosity and then the value is 5,000, it must be in writing. Next, number 3, the authority of the agent to sell a piece of land must be in writing. So, gas-gas na yan para sa inyo. Next is, number 4, the contract of partnership where an immovable property was contributed must be in public instrument. So, sa partnership, diba, si partner pwedeng magbigay ng cash or in kind. Pwede rin siyang magbigay ng kanyang industry. So, how about kapag ang ibinigay is real property or immovable? Either building or either land. So, kapag ang kinontribute ng isang partner is a real property, so dapat yung contract of partnership the contract of partnership must be in public instrument. So yung pagko-contribute mo must be in public instrument. So para yung contract of partnership becomes valid. Next is